Without a dog, you have no life here. We need dogs here for mountain work and gathering dock off the hill. And I don't know any farmer in Achill without a dog. My grandfather had dogs, but it was just a dog or a pup he got off a neighbour. But they were very wise dogs because they were outside from pups. They had the feel for the land and they were following you. Before long, they were running after sheep and they were going out for sheep. But at a very basic knowledge, like, you know, it was handed probably from him down to my father. Then, like, my father there, he started dealing with registered dogs. Mostly good farm dogs he had, but he was trying at a small level, like, on the farm kind of class. But he used to enjoy it, and I used to watch him and enjoy it. And he gave me my first pup, and I reared him and trained him. And to be honest, I thought I'm trained to an art. But when I went to my first trial, I weren't long finding out he wasn't trained. He was on come by, and he was on a way, and he was walking on with sheep, and he was driving sheep. But he weren't trained to a good art for trial. It was a whole different ballgame. I came home that day, and I said, right, you don't even know the half of it. So I had to go back to the drawing board. And I'm happy to say that I've been in the last three Irish Nationals, and this year now I finally got two dogs into the Irish National, and they're starting to win in Connacht, and it's a very good thing to be able to win in Connacht, because them dogs they'll be facing in an Irish National, and if you couldn't beat them in Connacht, you won't beat them in an Irish National either. Like, so if you get a dog from Achill that's working on that mountain, it don't matter where you go in the country, you won't get a dog what's going to outsmart him, because he's it all off by working through rocks, heather, bogland. Like, if I finish with a dog here on the mountain that cannot do it anymore, he might be 8 years old and he's getting too tired to go the mile and a half, and I sell him to a farmer up the country in lowland, he's capable of lasting another 5 years because he thinks it's heaven he's landed. He's saying this is easy, it's great. There's no need to look where I'm going here, it's all flat. You know, I'd have, say, four dogs at a fair good standard, and then I'd have four more coming up, maybe 2 years old. They'd be nearly finished, and I'd be knowing then which ones I want to keep for trialing, and maybe I want to keep one for just ordinary farm work around the house. And then I'd have another four coming up at a different stage, maybe at about 6 months. I'm not just going to finish off four and run out of dogs. I start all my young dogs in that garden there, that field there, the round pen first. Them pups to be there all day. I might bring out four or five dogs there for training, and they're all sitting down watching what's going on, and they're getting focused on their sheep. And if the sheep runs up past the pen, they're all running up trying to get out and ahead of them to stop them going up. And nothing better for somebody to come with a dog for training, and you bring him into that field there, and he runs through sheep, and he eats their wool, and he eats their head, and jumping on them and trying to catch them. And then in 3 or 4 weeks' time, that man comes back up for that dog, and he's lying down and he's walking after sheep, and he's like a whole different animal. If they could take over from there, it's great. But if someone asks you that you want him trained for the hill, to break a dog in a pen, you can nearly give a time in it, 3, 4 weeks, 5 weeks max. The hill is a whole different matter. They say a dog won't be a dog until he's a year under each paw. The last dog I brought out, he's coming up on 4 in September, and it's taken him all that time to get that experience. Now, they're the finished article. I could turn them dogs or twist them dogs any place I want to put them. But it does give me a great sense of joy when I finish off a dog, yes, even for myself, and get them up to a fine art. And it's an art that you have to train on. It just don't happen. As I said, you learn something new every day. And the more you watch, it could be just going down that road there to a local farmer, and you pass him and you see him doing something, and you're saying to yourself, boy, Christ, that's a cute way. And you say, I'll keep that now for my next training session, let's see, will it work? So you're always learning. Nobody knows it all. And I don't think anybody is ever going to know it all. We'll be learning until we finish up, and maybe the next generation might have learned what I know. Technology will never replace a dog. You have to go on foot, or the dog has to go for you. Sheep come over, they know you have no dog, and they'll go out of sight for 2 minutes on that hill. But once you start walking up that hill and you land that dip, there's no sign of sheep. They've doubled back on top of you, and they're gone back to the place that you're after picking them up. You bring your dog with you, you put him up that river, and bring him across, he does everything, he gathers everything up along his way, and he put them up where they came down from. I can't see anything ever replacing a dog. A collie dog is a man's best friend too. They're loyal to you, and if you're good to them, they'll trust you, and they'll follow you, and they want to be with you. And if another dog come up around you, you could tell they don't like it. They're jealous of him. But a dog is a man's best friend, and I tell you, a dog to me is everything. He does all my work here. He's not asking for much praise. Just a good dinner, good food, good digs, and he's happy. He's easy to look after.